Reclaim is an artificial intelligence application which enhances your calendar and your tasks. In today's video, we're going to overview it and see whether it's right for you as a busy professional or for you and your team. We're going to outline some of the AI features and give you an idea of whether it is a robust scheduling experience that is worth your buck. So welcome, my name is Francesco. We review tons of productivity tools, and if you're in the hunt for any of them, jump over to Toolfinder below. We've also just launched a newsletter called Tool Digest, which outlines the best productivity tools and new ones that have come to the market. You can find both of those linked below, but let's dive in. So as you can see, Reclaim is a smart calendar app that focuses on Google Calendar, and primarily at the moment, it is on Google Calendar. They do plan on adding Outlook, and it's currently only available for web. Now, this one's an interesting one because it's targeted towards teams, but also busy professionals. We're going to come on this perspective for both situations and hopefully answer the verdict a little bit later for both contexts. So I'm going to go log in and let's get started. So I've already been playing around with Reclaim, and largely Reclaim combines your task management and your priorities with your calendar, and it sort of fills a few gaps for you. It helps to plan your day like a calendar app, but also weave in your tasks like apps like Motion does. And it also has meeting scheduling externally, which means you can replace apps like Calendly, but also a way to manage meetings internally with you and your team so that you can do it automatically using AI. It's a strange application because there are a few on the market like it, and we're going to overview what it does. So here I've connected it with Google Calendar, and as you can see, it's bringing in my Google Calendar events. I've got a meeting coming up in half an hour, but you can also see that on this right-hand side, I've got my tasks for the day ahead as well. Now, let me show you it without that. Now, this is a calendar application element of it, and it's your planner for the day. And what you can see on here, first of all, is that I've got my calendar events here, but I've also got these boxes here for proposed activities. So in this case, if I click into this one, this is something that I've added to the priorities list that is gonna take me 5 hours to do. And it allows me to basically start scheduling that using AI into my calendar. So for example, you can see I've been working on this right now between 1 and 3 p.m. Now it also suggests that tomorrow after my meeting with Dan, I am going to do that work, and that's why it's in a slightly gray box with sort of cut out edges. Now, this is really interesting because this isn't something I dragged into the calendar. It's going off of a bunch of characteristics that I submitted as part of what I believe my priority item should be. So in this case, I'm going to be doing this at this time, but if I were to go over to priorities, I can see that task here, and let me show you what parameters I put around that task. So if I go to edit it, you can see that I set it up as a high priority item. There are actually four priorities in Reclaim: critical, high to low. You can also see how much time is needed and allow it to split it up. This makes it perfect. For example, I set 5 hours and the AI recommended that I do 2 hours this afternoon and 2 hours tomorrow after 11 p.m. after my meetings. I also set some parameters like what hours I want to do it in. You can have personal hours and working hours, which means that some tasks that maybe you're self-employed and need to get done can spill into your personal hours as well, outside of work. Obviously not a good habit you want to get into. But at the same time, you can set due dates, so that helps to differentiate the priorities as something that may or may not be important and influence the artificial intelligence. You can then also use it and set it as a visibility so that it blocks that time in your calendar. So if I press save, obviously I didn't change anything there. And as you can see, it's basically already distributed this. So it's just finishing this one, and it said that I've done 3 hours 75 and 2 hours prior to this as well. Now you can stop the timer if you want to, and as you can see, it updates it and gives an indication of whether I need to finish any work. So perfect, I think that's gonna do that in the background, which is great. And it moves me over to tasks. Now, tasks is pretty much anything that is any, like, all of your tasks brought into one. And the good thing with this application is it actually works better with integration. So you can connect up, at least in the free plan, Google Tasks, Raycast, Google Add-on, and even the likes of Slack, Zoom, and Outlook Calendar. These all help you to bring things up. Outlook Calendar is coming soon. And in the starter plan, you can connect Todoist, ClickUp, Jira, Asana, and Linear for more precise task management by consolidating them in your experience. We've seen this in apps like Sensama and Akiflow, and it's very popular on the market. So if you can imagine, I might add a few critical items. So for example, in this case, I could add one here to the task list. And in this case, I might set up something like complete tool finder reviews. And I want to add this as a critical item that I need to actually get done by Tuesday. And you can also schedule it after a certain time. So for example, if you don't want to start it till next week and it's got to be done by next Thursday, hypothetically, and you've got 3 hours to do it in, you can also set up the minimum duration. So in this case, 15 minutes and the maximum duration, 45 minutes. Maybe that will help to break it down even further to demonstrate. But you can also set it up, do not send to up next, which is that task management feature. If I go ahead and create this, what it's going to do in the background is use the AI to basically start planning it in my schedule. As I recommended it not to start till next week, it is actually going to put that in my calendar for Monday at 8:30. And you can see here that it's found a slot between my meeting at the gym and my gym session, which is a habit, which I'll explain in a bit, that I can get the task started on. And because it's split up from 15 minutes up into 15 to 45 minute blocks, and it's in my working hours from 8 a.m., which is when I set them to start, that's going to be great. It is also indicated that the due date is at 4:45, which is the end of the day on Thursday, because that's what I set my working hours to as well. And it's creating an outline of when I can complete it. And because it's a critical item, it's indicated that all of this time here is potential time to get that task done. So this is really, really helpful when getting started. And the one thing I can do is start adding a timer to it by pressing start, which means that the task is started and it gets logged as work, or I can backlog that task as a timer completed. So this is a really nice feature because you can start to see how the AI is utilizing the time. And if I were to add maybe some additional time into this one here, for example, it needs 7 hours and it needs to be done by next Saturday. And I'm going to put it as a medium priority and it has to be done in 2 hour stints. starting to sort of change some of the parameters of this. What it's going to do is in the background, it's going to recalculate what the best projection times are. And it believes I can get it done within these windows of time tomorrow. Perfect timing, my video cut out, but I wanted to demonstrate if I changed the information to schedule in advance, you can see that it is syncing in the background and my upcoming times are updating because I've changed the parameters to start next week. And because it is not critical, it's medium priority, it's moved it to Tuesday and Wednesday. So this is really helpful because it's constantly adapting to the situation. Now, in terms of the collaborative abilities that you might use for work, there's a feature called Smart One-to-Ones, which is a great way to be able to work with one person you routinely meet. For example, in this demonstration, I actually set one up that's a medium priority and a 30-minute weekly meeting with Bob. And from here, it's going to start next week, and ideally, it's going to be 2 p.m. Now, one-to-one smart links are actually apparently prioritized above habits and daily. So they're sort of non-movable things, but they naturally can adapt to the busyness of the week. So I have naturally set up this smart one-to-one, and these are the parameters that I've set it up on ideally. And it's got a few overlapping times already. But in this case, let's showcase where they're actually going to be. So for example, I want to set up a routine meeting with Bob. Now you can see here that that meeting has come up and squeezed in between these slots. So that is going to be my meeting with Bob next week. And you can start to see that Monday at the ideal time of 2 p.m. is already selected. And it will move this about based on a lot of different indicators. If this is, because I set this as medium priority, it's not necessarily as important as, say, the critical priority items. But at the moment, it's not impacting some of the work I'm doing because, rightfully so, I've got enough time in the day to complete the other type of tasks. So that's how one-to-one meetings goes. This is an adaptive thing that you can connect with a colleague and start planning together to effectively find the best slot for you. And that's basically how the team system works, because once you add more people to your planner, you can start getting them to add priorities of their own, blocking their time, and then starting to book meetings with other people. And this then permeates across your calendar and communicates with their calendar what is the best time to effectively meet that doesn't ruin each other's schedules. Now, finally, there are loads of features of this experience, but I wanted to touch on habits because I believe habits is one of the best features of this application. Now, habits are essentially simple little things you do every single day that you don't want to push or are important. So for example, lunch. This is a medium priority item. It's part of your personal and you want it to be 30 to an hour. And ideally you want to do it between these time slots, 11:30 and 2 p.m. So if I do that on every single day, an ideal time is 12, and I'm gonna press save. And what's gonna happen is it's gonna go through my calendar and essentially plot that in. Now, for most of these, it's actually just gone and put it bang in the middle, but it started to shuffle some of the items around. And when things get mental, it will start adapting them based on the best fit for you. So this is a really nice feature because it may knock back your lunch by 20 minutes if you've got a critical meeting or critical priority, but it won't, it won't sacrifice it like to the, sacrifice it to the gods. And the same with things like the gym one. I set a parameter like 15 to 45 minutes every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday between these hours, and then that's set there. But there are a bunch of different templates you can use. I remember the team showing me this like probably about a year and a half ago when I first communicated with them, and it was just one of those features that drew me into the experience because these are things that sometimes that teams forget and people forget. Like they just like, oh, I'll work through my lunch, but you don't need to if you've got some artificial intelligence going. Protect that time. And finally, I want to show you scheduling links. This is a booking page. So if I were to open it up, I can book a quick meeting with myself and it's going to use all of the smart times. And you can also see that this little green dot, I believe, is an indicator that they're bang perfect ones for me. And that's a short 15 minute meeting, but I can also add and enable the ability to add high priority meeting and flexible quick meetings, which means a flexible one, it's actually one that's quite adaptive. So it's gonna change for both people that are using it if something critical comes up. So that is the concept in itself. I like it in terms of what they've done with it, and I'm eager to continue to evolve my opinions on it. Now, pricing. Pricing isn't too bad. I go with the monthly normally because it gives you a better indication. So if you're using this for free and you want one scheduling link, one smart meeting, which I showed you, three habits and one calendar sync, which allows you to connect with Google Calendar. You can have multiple calendar, of course, which is part of the pro or the starter. Integrations limited, time tracking and tasks, then it's gonna be free, which is pretty good. And then if you look at the paid one, $10 per user per month, up to 10 users, three scheduling. This is great for a small team, especially when you're trying to just get started booking stuff and coordinating and better using each other's time. So actually I think that's fairly reasonable. But then if you want some serious access to unlimited smart meetings, unlimited scheduling links, that's $15 per month, which again, I think is not bad. There are some discounts here as well. But the thing that's different about this application is largely you could maybe replace apps like Motion and a calendar app and Calendly in one. So I guess it's sort of saving you a bit of costs to some extent there. So I'm largely impressed by this application. I would recommend it for busy professionals that want to be able to coordinate a time. I'm considering actually weaving it into my schedule, mainly because of the habits things. I suck sometimes at just pushing into lunch, and I think this will help it, but also keep priorities focused. So that was my review of Reclaim. If you're interested in it, you can check it out below. And naturally, you can read all of our reviews on Toolfinder, which dive into loads of productivity apps and resources. So I look forward to seeing you in a future video. Cheerio, and thank you very much.